together. Well, we used to, you know, we used to travel with two separate gospel groups. It was Casey and his, you know, his gospel group, and it was me and Dalvin, and we was in my dad's group. And then we had our own band, and everybody always told us about, you know, Casey and JoJo, y'all to hook up. So one day I said, well, let me go meet them. I met them, and I moved in with them, but we still wasn't a group. Like, for a whole year, I just lived with them. And I came to JoJo one day and said, yo, I'm going to start a group. Why don't you, you know, get down? So I wrote a song for my girlfriend, JoJo Got Down. That's how I started.
I was in gospel all my life, you know, since I was like real small. So I had my own gospel group. I recorded 3 gospel albums that did real good. And every day was singing gospel, going to church every day, 7 days a week. And, you know, I just, that's how it happened.
I love gospel music. We got a couple songs in our head that we want to do, you know, a couple nice songs. So, you know, that's later though. We don't want to confuse our audience right now.
Singing is all I know, but gospel singing is the only thing that I do know. That's why I try to put a lot of that into this, you know, R&B what I'm doing now, because I can't help it. You know, not that I try to sing gospel. Like, you know, when I do sing R&B songs, not that I try to sound like gospel. It's just in me. It's same thing as for Devontae, JoJo, and Mr. Dalvin. All our arrangements and everything is gospel. And that's something we can't help because we were just raised up around it every day.
And gospel, we was considered the bad boys of gospel, all of us. I don't know the switch. I don't know how that came about. We just started writing songs for girls around the neighborhood, and it just came there.
You don't want to get sex, baby. You don't want to get nasty. Baby, we can compromise and both get a little bit freaky. Right over here, let me rub that body. Maybe you would like a girl.
Because we try to be down to earth, so you know, and because we sing love songs, they think we bad boys. You know, I'm not gonna sit in and lie. You know, I mean, you know, you wanna. Sometimes, you know, we like to rumble. We'll do that too. But not bad boys. It's like somebody mess with you, you ain't gonna let them just make you look like a punk or nothing. You know what I'm saying? Hey, we're not bad boys. So I don't think so. If we was bad boys, our mother them probably wouldn't love us, and they still love us. So we can't be too bad, right? And a lot of ladies love us. And we love ladies too.
I'll cause whatever you want. I just make music, you know what I'm saying? All right. I'm not trying to be a bad boy. I'm not trying to be out here, but that's what you want to call me. You know, they call us rebels because we always go against the grain.
You always expect the unexpected. You never know what's going to happen next with, you know, my brother, Casey and Jojo, and the same, you know. We just do crazy things. Sometimes we do things like, oh, man, I can't believe you did that, you know. It's, you never know what they expect from you. So it's like a kind of like a spontaneous type group. We just do anything.
But I don't think people should praise getting in trouble. I don't think people should say, you know, I think people get wrapped up into the music so much that they want to actually live it out and whatever. If you're a hard rap group and you talk about, you know, killing them, whatever, and you get wrapped up into that, then, you know, I wouldn't even have a rap group on my label talking about that, promoting violence, promoting, you know, I'm not into that at all. You know, I don't think if they're going to do it, they shouldn't get caught up into it. And I don't think they should, you know, when trouble comes, I don't think they should act like they're not concerned about it. You know what I'm saying? I don't think they should take it. Like, I see, like, a lot of them on television after they get locked up or after whatever, and they act like they don't care. You know, I know that's just a role. I know they care. You know, they shouldn't, you know, go to the public with that.
Ain't nobody perfect. Anybody can slip. You know what I'm saying? Anybody can slip and make a wrong decision or whatever. But, you know, you just got to stay focused. You know, you just got to, and then you'll be all right. You'll be straight. That's what we try to do.
Yep, man. You know, so I'm trying to get out of here, man. You gotta keep beating me. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, oh, man. She's on tweaking, man. I'm gonna call somebody to lock his ass up.
Nigga, nigga, come lock you up, kid. You stay low. Five and treat them like they want to be treated as.
I don't think Snoop is really a hard, you know, he's not really a hard rapper talking about killing. You know, his music is just fun. I like Snoop and Tupac. You know, his last song, Keep Your Head Up, was positive to me. I don't know what happened, but, you know, I don't know, you know. I don't know. I listen to all of them, you know.
They're probably not bad boys, man. I can't say they're bad boys, man. I mean, because you can never... You can never judge nobody because you never know how they was raised up. You never know what environment they was around, you know, and probably you never know what they went through to live and to survive, man. So you can't call Snoop Dogg or Tupac or, you know, any other rappers. You can't call them bad boys, man, because you never know how they was brought up, man. You know, they probably was raised up fighting every day just to eat. You never know, man. So you can't just, you know, you can't just say that about them. I like them, you know, they cool with me.
I mean, everybody's got their way of, you know, I guess trying to expand or get exposure, but getting in trouble is not the move. You know, I'm a witness. That's not the move. You know, if I don't think you should go out and get in trouble on purpose and, you know, brag about it because ain't nothing fun about that. And that's like betraying a bad image. And a lot of times, you know, young people don't understand, you know, getting in trouble. And so they see one of their entertainers get in trouble. Oh, let's go get in trouble. Let's be like him. That's not a good image to betray. You know, so I don't suggest it. I don't recommend it.
It's called My Heart Belongs to You. What's up, BT? That's it. Watch me do that. Make sure you don't go flat on that part.
Whenever you want it in the evening. Whenever you need it, when the night falls, you know that I got it. So lady, just call me. You know that I'll do it.
Y'all watch the riff. You think it was?
Yeah. Want it. Need it. Right. Need it.
Alright. Whenever you want it.
want it in the evening, whenever you need it. Yo, hold on. Need it. That was it. So, lady, just call me. You know that I'll do it. All right. Hey, say goodbye to y'all, but I gotta go back to Ned for a little while. Let the Varsity do his little thing. Take my little throat thing for me. Let's talk to the camera, G.
Yo, I'm giving that same my note. I know people waiting to see because they never saw me sing. But y'all gotta feel me from them, man. Yo, Dr. Charles, roll the tape. Roll the tape.
This album is not different to me. It's like a continuation of the first album, you know? It's like you just, because a lot of the songs that we are doing, supposed to have, it's like we was going to put them on the first album, but we didn't, so we saved them to the second album, and we kind of got the same feel, and nothing has changed. With Jodeci, we still remain the same, and we will always remain the same, no matter what. And I still have one more track to do. They are telling me, so I'm going over here. All right.
Whatever you need, my heart belongs to you. Whatever you need, there's nothing I'll do.
I know I messed up in a second, but yeah.
I do whatever you want, my heart belongs to you.
All right, we're gonna go to the bridge. Yeah. You remember the word? All right.
Anything you want, I'll do it for you.
I just want everybody to know, you know, I started Jodeci. You know, it was me, my idea. You know, I don't say nothing because I'm waiting on the rest of the guys to tell the truth. And when they tell the truth, then I'm going to state my claim and get what's mine. Devontae is the brain of it. And Mr. Dallin is knocking all on the window. He's trying to tell me to cry. No, we all work as a group. But basically, Devontae is a brain of it. You know, he's a genius. He's good at what he do. He's great. And I admire him for that. But Vontae, like, he write most of the songs. And we just, Jodeci is like a, it's sort of like a, that's a good example, a car. A car couldn't roll without the tires. And they couldn't, a car couldn't operate without the motor and everything like that.
I look for a new song out of women. I look for inspiration.
There you go. Ooh. That's what I look for. Inspiration.
Yep. And you got it.
Give me the strength to the all.
You got everything that I need. Got everything that I need.
always lonely. I ain't got, you know, that's what I write about. I ain't got no woman. Need one. So you see this on BET, call 1-800. Jodeci, and ask for me. You get in touch with me. I'm easy to get in touch with.
1-800 lonely.
Oh, you went to the depths. Where do we get inspiration from?
Where do we get our inspiration from? Stevie Wonder.
Big up to Steve.
A bunch of you.
Big up.
Veterans, Marvin Gaye, Sam Cooke. Y'all crazy.
Lately I've had a strange feeling.
Do you know what I'm thinking about? Okay.
Lately I've had a strange feeling that you were gone.
I like to say, it's right now, you know, it's a group out there trying to take over our spot, whatever. We ain't got no spot, but they got a real short one with a big, and they got a tall one trying to be me, another one trying to be JoJo, and they got one. I guess he's you, Mr. Dallas.
I remember.
I like to say, them Keith, keep trying hard, Keith. Let's see.
There's only one JoJo, bro.
No, let me say about the media. We've been getting all kind of media press and everything. I just like to say, don't believe everything you read.
That's right.
Well, what is it about me and Casey? Don't believe everything you read. And everything you see on the news. You heard I got robbed. That's true. Don't believe everything you see.
Try it again. That's all I got, son. Bring it from the heart. Stick over down.
We're just in the studio bugging out, you know, a little late night Jodeci short takes. That's all it is. Whatever you want to say about that.
Oh, yo, big up to BET too, man.
Yeah, big up.
Big up, everything.
The whole staff.
Nally Wood.
I want to say thanks, sir. Thanks to all.
Nally Wood.
Dallas Brothers, say something
simple.
What we're going to do today is do a little styling. As you know what Jodeci Image is all about. So we're going to this platform store and see if we find anything that might just fit our attire.
What's a
fat deck? All of our stuff is extra large, you know. Real baggy. Stink. It all ties into one image. It's like, kind of, it's a little bit above a street level. It's more like a on the edge kind of tip, I guess. You know, it's just not regular hip hop fashions. Or, you know, what we might wear on stage is not just regular. It's just like over the edge, maybe like rock and roll or something. Hip hop Guns N' Roses, you might say. Imagine Guns N' Roses, some hip hop gear. Sybil might tell you a little something. She's been with us for a while, too.
Well, I mean, we're just trying to put Jodeci to where a place where no hip-hop band has ever touched yet. You know, we're open for all types of suggestions. We don't just get locked into one specific designer or any store. We like to take something that's not hip-hop and make it hip-hop,
right,
you know,
right.
So we can lead the trend instead of follow it. So that's what we're trying to do with Jodeci.
So far, that's what you've been doing. Booyah. So I guess we spot the green jackets, we're gonna come back and get them. So we're gonna go to a few more spots, I guess. Stay tuned, I guess, to see what's up. I can't tell you our secrets though. And what we have here is what we call a Jodeci type car. It's not your regular BMW, you know. A few additives I add on, lowered it a little bit, rims. So all of you that need help, you know, making your cars look a little something. 1-900 Jodeci hookup. That's how you hook up your cars. But anyway, what we're gonna do a little bit today is a little Jodeci fashion, because people know us to be singers or whatever. But Jodeci is real high on fashions too. That's like one of the main things of our group. Because as you notice, you never see us wear the same thing twice. whether we're on stage. And we always set new trends, you know, as far as the way we dress. We get a lot of complaints about it, but you'll be all right. Then again, it's real hard for Josie to shop in stores because a lot of stuff are handmade. A lot of stuff is handmade, brother. And because we have ideas that we and stuff will come together and we like, this is Josie. And we know we can't find half the stuff we want in stores, so therefore we get it made. We won't tell you that, Spotty. We won't take you that.
Most of the time we're looking for accessories too. You know, that's a lot of things we're out here for. To find something that's gonna add flavor to what Dalvin thinks should be made. A hat here, a belt here, some new boots here. So a lot of times we come to areas like that for
that. What she's saying, if you hear somebody talking in the background, this right here, she's working with us here. She's pointing to some hats. The most hats that we wear, like Casey may wear a top hat. Jojo wears White Sox baseball cap. You know, a lot of baseball caps. This right here, we might wear, you know, going to bed or something. But, can y'all put this on camera? This work? No? Okay. Well, from the beginning, we always had our street image, you know, they try to cross us over into suits, but none of that. We always had a real edgy, controversial look, you know, as far as, you know, we came out with the boots, the hoodies, the jeans, and so forth.
Sagging. More, giving the people more what they want.
Right.
Because they may not know they want it, so Josie puts it on, then they want it. Like, you know what I'm saying?
See, what this is mostly like, I guess, like a Bath and Body Works store, you know. And you'd be surprised what kind of stuff you might find in here. It's not called Bath and Body Works, it's called Origin. You'd be surprised what kind of stuff you might find in here. I found this fat jacket I'm trying on right now.
That
one's
small, but double XL.
But it's dope.
That should be dope.
You'll definitely see this on us.
First time Jodeci.
Right.
Followed by
whoever else.
Everybody else.
What this is a seatbelt, like, with beer bottle tops on it. And it's like something different. So everything we're, even to our belts, is something distinctive. So just let you know, it's something like that. Bear in mind, it's a soap store. Thank you all. See you later.
Thank you very much.
Well, is the Jodeci image really us, or is it something that we made up? It's definitely us because we dress how we feel, you know. We put on what we feel like, you know. And as far as the jean there, then we do what we feel comfortable in, and we want to feel like, you know, the everyday person. We don't want to put on sequins or, you know, a lot of glamour. We feel like we know we're a lot better than anybody else, so therefore we dress, you know, like we're regular people. So that's how we dress, regular.
Bigger, four, black sugar. Can't get enough of this stuff, it's good, nigga.
I have a lot of insight, or I have a lot of images or visions of to what we could wear, and you know, I take that real serious. And everybody in our group has a different, like, you know, job, couple of different jobs. You know, as far as the images, they put me in in charge, as well as Civil, because we have a lot of visions, or you know, we take time or whatever, and we take it real serious. So they depend on us, you know, as far as the image. But they have a lot of input as far as when we come back. They don't want to wear something, they definitely ain't putting it on.
Right.
You know, it's not like we bring them something, they say, okay, cool. You know, a lot of times we sit there and argue before we go on stage, before we do a photo session. Yo, this looks good. I don't like that. And, you know, we go another direction. Even if we spent $5,000 on it, we go a different whole direction. Our basic format is like, you know, maybe black jeans and boots. And we want like a lot of different, you know, we may spend like maybe $800 a jacket, or, you know, $1,000 a jacket. You know, we dress for expensive according to how, you know, we might want that look to go as far as we want. You know, as we do a song, we might want a certain look for a song. So, you know, we jackets, leather jackets and different kinds of jackets and tops is like a big part of our image too.
They got some new ones coming in. Like something like this you can do with the newer, but they got
the black one?
Yeah. That. See, that's a different trend to it, but it's some of the other stuff they've already done. I mean, we can do some. They got some new stuff coming in.
Right.
All right, let's take him on down the street, Dad, and see what other flavors we can find.
Let's see.
What's your name? You a movie star?
No, I'm not a movie star.
You got anything suggestions for us?
I find all my clothes in the drop.
Here we go, live on the set. Here's this Jodeci video fiending. Got the girls, the divas in here.
I'm gonna get the shotgun.
Come on, bye.
I'm gonna get the shotgun right.
Oh, okay. See, she's hooking me up so I don't look like a rep laying on. But we got the divas in here working hair, working wardrobe, feeding faces. Say hi, y'all.
Hey.
You'll see their work later when y'all see the video.
Wardrobe person.
Yo, Yaya, everybody behind the camera.
Except for Rick is ready.
What is that
gonna do? We're down here at the Jodeci Video Phoenix. My man Hype Williams, director of Life from Big Dog Films. What's going on?
Not much, man. Just getting this thing done now.
So you kind of stressed, a little hectic for you.
Definitely.
What's going on?
See,
they don't really know. We ain't exactly on schedule today.
Action.
Well, how'd you and Devontae hook up?
They gave me a call. They said that, you know, they like the look of things, and you know, D wanted to work with somebody. And, you know, I guess I was the best candidate, so we kind of, like, vibed, and I think we're going to get the best product that way.
Now, everything was cool from the get-go. Y'all had the same kind of idea, so were y'all, like, really shocked at each other's
heads? No. Actually, we was on the same page. You came, you said, yo, this is what I want to do. I saw it the same way, and, you know, basically, we're just going to make it happen.
So how is he as a director? You leading him a whole lot?
Nah. D's going to big up as a director this year.
Yeah, he's holding his own?
Definitely holding his own.
So is this going to be like X-rated? See, I know the concept. Did y'all have to tone it down about 1,000?
This is a totally, totally different feel for Jodeci. They're definitely working on more of a visual scale with this. And basically, we're trying to bring out the element that the album is supposed to portray, like Diary of a Madman. So it's basically based on them and their characteristics and how they're portrayed in society, as opposed to, like, you know, we're not even going down that page with, like, the, you know, the women and things like that.
So I got the man here in charge, Devontae Swing, who's running things, and his leading lady. All right, now did you do all the casting for this?
I did a lot of the casting for this.
And what made you pick Miss Kimmy Kim?
This has been a long-time friend of mine, you know. She was the most beautiful girl I know. So I asked her to do the video, say yes.
So why did you choose this video to direct? Why not Crosby you?
At the time, I'm working with 8 other groups, and I didn't have time to do Crosby, and, you know, I trust Puffy, you know.
Mm.
I told Puffy, you know, all right, the band said, we can let Puffy do this one.
So you and Puffy ain't have no static about this one?
No. Leave me and Puffy straight.
Oh, okay. Now, the whole concept of the video, is that you? That you and Hype? That's you and the rest of Jodeci?
Mm-hmm. The whole concept? You want the concept
of
the video?
I want the concept.
Concept of the video is, you know, it's mainly like we're hanging out with a couple of, you know, friends and homeboys, and you know, they think we're going crazy because we're paying a lot of attention to these females, you know, main ladies and whatever, and they call us, you know, authorities on us. They think we're going crazy, so they want studies on us, see what's going on.
Sounds a little true to life there, is it? we won't go there. We definitely won't go there. So are you going to do other videos outside of Jodeci, or are you going to do maybe a Mary or a Heavy, or just your group even?
My groups. A few. I'm not trying to get into this, like, you know, full time. It's just, you know, I had a couple of ideas, and, you know, I personally, I didn't like none of the Jodeci videos that much, so.
Really? None of them?
It, okay. It wasn't like, you know, like bombs in there. Okay.
So this one's going to be it.
Yeah.
How's it working with Devontae on a directorial tip? I mean, I know y'all are used to him and everything, but has it been like?
We don't like Devontae. We mad, and we're going to find him and fight him.
Yeah.
So we're looking for him right now. We don't like Devontae. He's a hard director.
We're gonna break him off.
We're gonna break him off something proper like. Now he's cool. He's a good director. This is his first project. He's done real good, you know.
Well, it's nice to have that kind of support. So y'all gonna be directing too?
Hopefully. Maybe. You know, our own groups probably.
Really?
You know, yeah.
Y'all don't want to do like your own stuff, the next video, the next single?
Well, we all collaborate, I guess, on the directing tip, I guess.
So what's coming up with the tour and everything?
Well, we're getting that together now. We're geared to go do Soul Train and, you know, Jay Leno, Arsenio, a bunch of TV shows, and then we're going on like a world tour.
Starting about what, May, April?
End of June. End of June. Yeah.
Hey, who was the makeup lady? Miss Toxic.
So?
Oh, you're old down too.
So how's the album doing? The
album is doing good, man. It's slamming. A lot of good reviews, and everybody seems to like it. So, you know, whoever don't have it, go get it. You know, check it out. You might like it. You know what I'm saying?
That's right. Y'all heard it here. The album's in full effect. What is it, double, triple platinum now? Quadruple platinum
is
going. It's on its way.
It's creeping slowly but surely.
All right. Well, here you go. Jodeci in full effect with Feenan.
That's right.
Dalvin, Casey, the house. One in the show.